Everybody, it's Invicta, and it's time for another Solo Queue Silliness here on the channel. Today, I'm going to be playing as Muradin. I've gotten a lot of requests for people requesting the Stormbolt build, especially on the newest patch. They wanted to see if it was affected, and to be quite honest, I don't repatch notes that often, so I have no idea. I don't think that they changed anything with the Stormbolt build, but I could be wrong. You never know. I'm going to be going for a little bit of a variant today. I'm going to be going not only in the not only for the Stormbolt-y build, but I'm also going to add the level 20 Talent Executioner. Executioner, you deal 40% more damage against slowed, rooted, and stunned targets. And of course, we do have Thunderclap, which does slow them for 2.5 seconds. So I have a 2.5 second window to do a ton of damage on enemy heroes. That's what I'm going to be gunning for today. On our team today, we got Sergeant Hammer, Tykus, Zagara, Muradin, Tyrael, and Tassadar taking on Vala, Tassadar. Oh wait, no, Tassadar is on their team. Look, I know what I'm talking about. Tassadar, Vala, Chen, Tyrone, and ETC. So, needless to say, it's going to be quite the slugfest because not really, either team really doesn't have a whole lot of damage. I mean, we have Tykus, they have Vala, but that's about it. Zagara does, of course, does adequate damage. I was able to land my first Stormbolt, so that's already a good sign. And yeah, I will say this is the first game that I played today, and I also have not played Muradin in quite a while, so expect a little bit of sloppiness. Expect just for a little, just give me a little bit of leniency, that's all I'll ask for that way. I'm gonna go see if I can help Tyrael down here. Well, I'm one for two on Stormbolt, so I'm not really that's 50%. That's okay. It's not even a that's kind of an F, but that's okay. Wouldn't expect anything less for that. I landed the Stormbolt. It was on an enemy minion, so there's that. I didn't think I was actually gonna hit that creep, but apparently I did. All right. Now, of course, with Stormbolt, what it is basically you want to be. Every time your Stormbolt comes off of cooldown, that was not the right button there, Muradin. Every time my Stormbolt comes off of cooldown, I want to be landing it on an enemy hero, not a minion. And what that does is it permanently, this is the Perfect Storm, by the way, Perfect Storm talent, level 1. What it does is it permanently increases the damage of Stormbolt by 5 every single time I hit an enemy hero with it. Yeah, I was able to hit that as well. Back on out of there. Yeah, Tyrael saying that we're going to need someone in range. Some ranged hero in mid, which I don't really think we need anyone ranged. We can fight up against the turrets, not that big of a deal. And we certainly shouldn't be having Tykus coming up from bottom.
Defend our fort.
Yeah, we're gonna need somebody to go bottom. We can't have three in mid and none in bottom. That's how you lose XP. I'm not sure how that Stormbolt didn't land, actually. Of course, I'm going to go with Sledgehammer. Sledgehammer does an increased amount of damage to minions, structures, and mercenaries. And that is what gives... That's what gives Muradin a lot of firepower later on whenever he can solo boss camps, that sort of thing. When his Stormbolts are hitting like 1,600 or more. Of course, I don't have any mana, so I can't hit Tyrone with one quite yet. Going to be looking for it, though. There we go. Landed my stun. Tyrone missed her stun. That's okay. Going to back up. You see second wind kicking in whenever Muradin is out of combat for, I think, 3 seconds? 4 seconds? He starts regenerating a lot of health very quickly. That is why he is so good for tanky. For tankiness along with everything else. I'm going to head up to the top. And let's see if we can get this first tribute. So we do see Tassadar coming up from mid. Of course, I'm going to be focusing on taking out not ETC, and of course, that's also under the assumption that I'm able to land my abilities here. I was able to get Tassadar off of the cap. There we go. There's no way I wasn't going to hit somebody. They had three of them there. There's no way I wasn't going to at least hit somebody with the Stormbolt. ETC's almost dead. Dwarf toss on him. See you later. Down he goes. Could not get away from Tyrone. I was able to land the Stormbolt. Chen goes down as well. So all the tanks have pretty much died, including Tyrael as well. Actually, Tyrael's still in mid. Probably not the best place to go cap the tribute, but that's okay. I was expecting Tyrael to be up there. But that's alright. We wouldn't have a solo queue silliness either way. So enemy team takes the first tribute, not that big of a deal. First tribute really doesn't mean a whole lot. It's the second tribute that's very important, and that's the one that we cannot afford to lose. Because if you go down, by two tributes early on in this map, it is very, very difficult to come back. I don't want to say come back, but it's very difficult to... It's very difficult to, like, get an early lead, I think is the best Kirk Derp way I can explain that. I'm going to go with Piercing Bolt just because it does allow me to hit two targets, so if the enemy heroes line up, I am going to be able to hit not one, but two, thereby doubling my chance to engage and to increase the damage of my Storm Bolt. I'm going to come around back here and see if I can land it on somebody. There we go, I landed on ETC. Tribute does again spawn up top. Just going to back up here. And this is the one that we absolutely have to get. Chen solo farming up top is not good. We need to have somebody up in all lanes soaking XP. Otherwise, it's not going to be a fun time. So Chen versus Muradin, pretty much the most boring battle of all time. I was able to land that on Tassadar. I tried to stun him. I was hoping that Zagara was going to throw the Banelings towards Tassadar. But this is an exciting slugfest right here. Stormbolt, I was able to stop him from drinking. Shout out to Tyrael. It looks like we have found our that guy. Ping function does indeed work. I'm going to go up here and hopefully dwarf tops myself over to the fountain. You did see Tyrael, or you did see Tyrande's sentinel try to snipe. Oh, that's right. I didn't go anywhere, ETC. I just went to go tap the fountain. I'm still here fighting. All right, land the Storm Bolt. Can't we get him? See you later. Down goes Chen. Essentially, you've been fighting a 3 versus 4 up top. Sergeant Hammer didn't even try to come up here. I don't think I saw Tychus either. That's all right. We somehow got it, and hey, that's the most important one of the game. That's second tribute, man. ETC, and I'm just going to continue to annoy him there. He get Haymaker. Let's see if I can punch him back towards us. There you go. Get punted, ETC. Nice double stun there by Tyrael. What a nice play by Tyrael. Got to give that guy credit. Excellent, excellent job with the timing there. Waiting for Haymaker. I don't know if he was waiting for Haymaker or if he just saw an opportunity. Either way, that was a very good play there by the Tyrael player. And that is definitely how we got that kill. So, Tribute's going to be spawning down bottom, and Sergeant Hammer and Tychus just going to wait for reinforcements. Definitely a good idea. Tychus going to start the cap. There is good old Tassadar, and now it's time to start playing the zoning game. We just dare them to try to engage this. There comes Vengeance coming in from Vala. Gonna punch ETC away so he cannot hit the mosh pit. Down goes Tassadar. Down goes we got somebody else. I'm still gonna go after Vala here. Maybe not. Oh, 1.5 seconds away from hitting the Storm Bolt. That's all right. We end up trading a 4-for-1. Can't really complain there. I really shouldn't have died. To be quite honest, I did not time my Storm Bolts very good there. I'm doing decent on the perfect storm damage. Does an extra 70 damage. Points worth of damage extra. So far, fairly close game, although I will say that the enemy team has been doing a better job farming the lanes. They've been just getting more XP, although don't let the numbers fool you. I feel like that the enemy team's been doing that anyway. Zagara going to be taken down in the night camp. Going to try to stop this minion wave here. Did you Storm Bolt? You saw the increased damage it did to the creep. Normally I go for the Thunder Strike. I'm going to go for Burning Rage this time around though, because I need to save my mana, not for Thunderclap, but I need to save it for Storm Bolts and more importantly Haymaker. Here we go. I'm just going to wait for Chen to get here, and Tychus almost pushed me out of the bush. I did land Haymaker. I don't know what happened, but I didn't actually land Haymaker. I don't know what happened there, but I was trying to land it on Chen so he would push he would push ETC out of the mosh pit, and it, I guess Haymaker didn't go off. I'm not sure what displaced me versus ETC. Death Star's in the way. You gotta move. Get out of here. Get out of here, Death Star. Let's see if I can catch up to Chen here and Haymaker and back into our team. I can also just simply storm bolt him. There we go. I did land the Haymaker on ETC, by the way. It just killed him. But watch how much damage Stormbolt does to the structure. 1,040. So much damage, man. Sledgehammer is where it is at. Sledgehammer is the talent that I took early on that increases the Stormbolt damage by 400% to mercenaries, towers, structures, and creep. So I'm going to go right for it here. And yeah, 1,080 on the hit for the Grave Golem. That is the real gimmick of the entire build. There's not really much of the stun. The stun's very nice, but it's the added damage, the pushing power of Murden. You see how fast, how quickly we burn down that golem.
Enough. I shall
without you. There we go. We're just clearing away their night camp. Lickety split. I'm going to go into a little bit of mana regen phase here and just basic attack. I will use Storm Bolts to continually up the damage if I can, if I can land it. For the most part, I'm going to be using them for pushing down the forts themselves. There's the Executioner. Basic attacks deal 40% more damage to slowed or stunned targets. And as you can imagine, that is quite a bit of damage here. Somehow the Storm Bolt didn't land on either Vala or the Keep. Rather. I'm not sure how that was even possible, but apparently that happened. I go ahead and back out. Run, Zagar, run! I wasn't able to land the Stormbolt on Chen. I push ETC away from everybody because I knew that he was going for that mosh pit, especially when all of them have used their ults. I go back and get some mana here and get right back to it. See if I can save Tychus. There you go. So you see I'm hitting for 227 for a basic attack. That is as a warrior, by the way, obviously. And the drill is actually doing a surprising amount of damage to Chen there. He's forced to back away. Don't know what ETC's doing, but he's not paying attention at all. I'm not sure what ETC did. He may have actually DC'd. Not sure. Not going to question him. Okay, so we get the fort. And let's see if we can get Vala here. That was not Haymaker, by the way. That was Sergeant Hammer's powerful blast. I forget the name of that ability. Get over there, Chen. You're not going anywhere. Who shall carry? See you later. Down he goes, man. Haymaker's so good for displacing heroes. This is kind of what I'm. This is what I was talking about. I was harping on earlier. This build just makes Murden fun for me. If I wasn't playing this build with Murden, I honestly wouldn't be playing Murden at all. So I am going to cap it here. You see how much second wind heals for. 73 hit points a tick out of combat. There goes Justice going in. Justice using Judgment. There's the stun I land on Tyrone. Gonna slow her down, and there you go. Executioner damage, man. I'm telling you, it's good. I'm gonna wait for. I'm not gonna jump in the mosh pit, obviously. I hope it's up. And Executioner, see you later. Down goes ETC. Not even a chance. Next time. And here comes the payoff. We have an extra 105 Stormbolt damage, which actually, truth be told, isn't that much. But let's see how much damage it does to this keep here. Yeah, 1,300 damage in one Stormbolt. 1,300 damage every 10 seconds, by the way. Out comes the Vulcan Drill here, and or the Draken Drill, rather. Is it Draken or Vulcan? I want to say Draken. Tychus is Draken Laser Drill, yep. Close enough. The Raven Lord demands tribute. Tribute spawns down bottom. The enemy team is in a lot, and I mean a lot of trouble. There you go, Chen doesn't want a piece. Murden wants the whole damn thing, though. I was thinking about grabbing the Watchtower first, but I think that'd be a little bit silly. Enemy team has no chance of getting this. They've got, well, they did have one down, but yeah, they're way out of position. Enemy team is in so much trouble. I'm gonna go down here and soak the bottom lane because there's just a ton of creep down here. Yeah, we should definitely wait for the last tribute before we go after the boss. Which is the reason why I'm not going after it right now. I'm just going to try to make up a little bit of XP. That was a lot of lost XP there if we didn't have someone down here soaking it. Again, with Burning Rage, did you see that's that 48 tick that's going on. I passively deal a set amount of damage to anything that's around me, including heroes. Looks like they're just going to cap it right now. All right. I'm going to go help Zagara get this Night Camp real quick. Boom, boom, boom! Look at that, one-shotting that knight up top. There we go. I'm gonna go back and get some mana. Even though I could regen it, the next tribute is gonna be probably, hopefully, the last one. I'd like to have full mana here just in case. And we're almost at full build here, with level 20 coming right around the corner. Team Solo Q mid silliness 9, rocking and rolling now. Look at the jump and siege damage that I've done thanks to that, thanks to the sledgehammer. So the enemy team's still having to deal with the boss down below. Again, I do feel that we capped the boss a little too early. We should have had the boss here for this. Oh, Interior! If you had any question if he was a, if he was one of the that guys, now you've got it. Throwing out the offensive GG. And I'm on his team. Mosh pit, but what is that really going to do? Not a lot. I'm gonna go for rewind here. That allows me to reset my cooldowns very quickly. Gotta land the storm bolt on ETC. Down goes one. And I'm just gonna go on in, man. I don't even care. I use rewind again. Down goes Tyrone. See you later. Going toe to toe with Tastar in Archon mode. Back up a bit. I tried to save Tyrael. Didn't happen. Doing a decent amount of damage there on Shen. I have to regen real quick here. Keep destroyed. You get the keep. I might as well just take out the Siege Giants real quick. Just for good measure. ~1500 damage, man. Stormbolt hits so hard right now. I love it. I love it. Take out all the keeps. It does look like we did lose Sergeant Hammer there. But again, look how much healing, passive healing that Murden has. That's just from his trait. And that is why he is so amazing. Watch how much damage we do to the core here. Boom! 1540 damage. Oh man, final total 22-12. I end up finishing third in siege damage, not that big of a deal. But hey, a win's a win. I'll take it. Thanks for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. See you next time here on the channel for more Solo Q silliness. Until then. So long, everybody.